नमस्ते, माय नेम इज़ JVN ऋषि गौतम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जर्नलिज्म। टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ द रोल ऑफ मीडिया इन पीस बिल्डिंग, यानी कि शांति बहाली में मीडिया की भूमिका। द रोल ऑफ मीडिया इन पीस बिल्डिंग। हिस्ट्री हैज शोन दैट द मीडिया कैन इंसाइट पीपल टुवर्ड्स वायलेंस। हिटलर यूज्ड द मीडिया टू क्रिएट एन एंटायर वर्ल्ड व्यू ऑफ हेट्रेड फॉर ज्यूस, होमोसेक्सुअल एंड अदर माइनॉरिटी ग्रुप्स। Rwanda's radio RTLM urged listeners to pick up machetes and take to the streets to kill what they called the cockroaches. Broadcasters in the Balkans polarized local communities to the point where violence became an acceptable tool for addressing grievances. The media's impact on the escalation of conflict is more widely recognized than the media's impact on peace building. Yet, it is not uncommon to hear experts pronounce that the media's impact on peace building must be significant given its powerful impact on conflict. However, this simple relationship must not be taken for granted and should be critically examined in order to most effectively use the media for conflict prevention and peace building. In the last 6 decades, the influence of the media in the global arena has increasingly been recognized, especially its power to either exacerbate or contain potential conflicts. Indeed, it is worth nothing that among the defendants during the Nuremberg trials, which were constituted by the Allied forces following the defeat of the Germany and her allies immediately after the Second World War, was one Julius Streicher, who, although never held any official position within the Nazi Party hierarchy, was considered to be among the top individuals who bore the greatest responsibility for the Holocaust that killed more than 6 million Jews. Nuremberg trial papers for close to 25 years, Streicher had educated the Germany people in hatred and incited them to the persecution and the extermination of the Jewish race. The propaganda which Streicher carried for close to 25 years was chiefly done through the medium of his newspaper as the editor of the Dr. Estoumer and later several other provincial journals, May 24, 1934 issue. As early as the 17th century, Edmund Burke had coined the term the fourth state to demonstrate the growing power of the media in periods when power and influence was concentrated in hands of only three classes of society, although it is still debatable as who was the first to use the word. Burke is said to have remarked that there were states in Parliament, but the Lords spiritual, the Lords temporal, and the Commons. In the last 50 years, the media influence has grown exponentially with the advance of technology. First there was the telegraph, then the radio, the newspaper, magazines, television, and now the internet. Many people are today fully dependent on the information and communication to keep moving in the right direction and their daily activity like work, entertainment, healthcare, education, personal relationships, traveling are greatly controlled by what they read, hear, and see. New communications technologies such as mobile, video phones, and laptop computers are allowing journalists to gather and disseminate information with ease from many parts of the world. We see news images of demonstrations, riots, or cops within minutes of those occurring in the streets. These images not only inform global audiences, but many instigate further campaigns of violence at home. Commercial realities of news gathering have also affected the reporting of conflicts. The higher cost of news gathering in remote regions, coupled with the geopolitical and economic priorities of the West, mean that conflicts occurring at close proximity to the metropolitan centers receive coverage at the expense of those occurring further away in less developed regions of the world. Thank you.